Hey there, everyone. Welcome to another edition of Horizon Insider. I'm out here at Eli Field today with the beautiful E-flite Sukhoi 30, the SU-30, twin 70mm EDF jet, foam construction. Now, if you're anything like me, when you saw the video of this, when you saw the photos of this, A, you noticed this thing looks amazingly scaled, but B, one thing you probably didn't pick up on is the size of this. I did not know this plane was going to be this big. When you compare this to a 64mm or even a 70mm EDF jet side by side, there's almost no comparison. So don't really think about this as being in the same class as like 70mm EDF jets, because this thing is huge. Now, with that size comes the ability for us to do extra scale detail. So things like the panel lines, the paint job, the ordnance, the wheels, the tires, the landing gear, the actual ability for the landing gear doors to be sequenced, the gear rotates to fit in the airframe, there's lights, it's all sprung, so you have that extra little give upon rough landings. Everything about this, the pilot figure in here, that every single bit was really thought out and scaled to kind of the umpteenth degree we could with a foam plane. Now, with that size obviously becomes the limitations of airfield. So with that being said, a expertly skilled pilot could probably fly this at a small club. Someone like me who's still kind of at the intermediate level, we really need to look for a large flying field. And that's simply because of the fact that this takes up space. You know, you have to fly this fast. It's an EDF. It's also a fairly heavily loaded EDF in general. So you really need that extra comfort zone to kind of get used to the plane and the flight envelope. Also, keep in mind, if you plan on using Safe Select to fly this, that's going to expand the field limitations as well, because Safe Select only going to allow it to pitch and bank a certain degree. So you really need to have enough room to do a large circuit with a jet this size. Really any jet, but this one in particular, because this is essentially our largest one right now as of 2020. Now, I mentioned Safe Select, which I have assigned on this. This also has AS3X stability. So again, that's gonna help combat the wind. It's basically just a gyro stabilization system, which is on always. So you'll probably see the majority of the flight, I'll be flying in AS3X only mode. But again, I always bind in Safe Select, especially considering I have a sun that's gonna be kind of overhead. That way, if you fly through the sun, like I mentioned, or a bug attacks you, or you wanna hand off the controller, you have that extra kind of crutch to lean on while you do that or recover from that situation. And then finally, some of the other nuts and bolts of this plane, you know, you have a full flying stab, just like the real jet. You do not have thrust vectoring like a real SU, unfortunately. But again, you have rudders on both of the vertical stabilizers, nice big ailerons. You have a steerable nose wheel, and you actually get this really cool spoiler, just like the real jet. Now, keep in mind, with me running through all that functionality, you really kind of need a 7 or 8 channel to take advantage of all these functions. You could get away with a 6 channel, but then you're gonna kind of either have to sacrifice that air brake, which obviously is gonna increase landing speed, or I shouldn't say landing speed, but decelerating speed once you're on the ground, or you're gonna have to compromise and not use Safe Select. So those are key things to keep in mind. If you're using a 6 channel, you could get away with flying this, but it's really not ideal. Now, I will be flying this today with the 6S5000. So this will actually accommodate up to a 7000, but I just personally have 6S5000s. Really, the purpose of this video is for me to really highlight the airframe, the plane, the details itself, but we're gonna do a little bit of flying as well. So I hope you enjoy. and that is the E-flite SU-30. A pretty unbelievable jet, really. It's, despite its size and the twin motors, it's actually fairly calm and docile. It's almost like flying a true turbine RC jet to an extent. Very predictable, but again, you do need space. You know, this is going to eat up a lot of space, especially if you're someone with experience level similar to me, or maybe really getting into larger EDFs. Just keep in mind, go to a flying field. Don't try to take this off at a park or anything. So other than that, that is all we have for you. Thanks for tuning in to this edition of Horizon Insider. We'll see you in the next one.